this week. And right now, studying this morning, he's very active with the ball and throws a great fade route. He gets it out of his hands and doesn't take sacks very often. Once in a while, he'll get a little rattled back there, but most of the time, he cuts the ball loose, throws it out of bounds, makes good decisions with the football, and he really has developed into a very, very good passer.
Yeah, they've got receiver Lippitt, who I think leads the Big Ten in yards per catch, and they do like 21 yards. Is he just going deep all the time, or is he just breaking tackles? What makes him deep?
No, he's got a little bit of everything. He really does. He's got some patience in the route. You see him really set defenders up. But he also has some ability after the catch. And he's a big guy and can run pretty well. So we're going to have to do some things to try to stifle him a little bit.
Is this the Big Ten's best defense that you'll be facing? Because I know the numbers got skewed a little bit with the Oregon game. But when you look at this, is this as formidable defenses you're
going to play all year? Well, I haven't studied all the defenses in the conference, but I'd be hard fought to find a defense as good as these guys. They're excellent. I mean, they play their typical cover four coverage where they're going to play man-to-man on the outside, play nine guys in the box. They have great eye discipline. Typically, you'll see guys that are peeking to see what the play act. These guys have unbelievable eye discipline on the edges, and their safeties are basically linebackers. They're down in the box as soon as the quarterback takes the snap. This is a very sound defense. And when they get you in third and long, watch out, because here comes something.